Hi guys, this is Skidflash here, and welcome back to Let's Play Aviary Attorney. In the last part, we actually beat the game, and on a whim, I decided to get the other endings. And this involves the bad ending, where shit gets real, Falcon decides to commit some mad murder, Sparrowson takes charge, and it's all just a wacky turn of events, man. But let's just keep on going for the lulz. You gotta get all the things you can view from this game, huh? This is just so sad, though, he's talking to himself. I'm a little nervous. You don't worry. A guilty verdict is all but guaranteed. I know, it's just scary because this is my first time presenting a case as a lawyer, not as an assistant. Do we have evidence? Nothing. I should get an assistant. Ah, okay. So who's gonna be on the other side? Oh, okay. No lawyers. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. Are all the jury present? Yep. Okay. Uh-huh. That's your cue, madam. You can see I'm here to skip the pantomime nonsense and convict me already. Now we have a procedure to follow. Let's do this right. Okay. First, you're charged of that. The benevolent prosecutor? What a joke of a phrase. Hey, you shut your mouth. Second, you're charged with conspiring to incite a rebellion. And we shall have our rebellion. Your third charge of the murder of Ken, sure, why not? In fact, I myself bore witness to the murder of Severin Kokoriko. I could even deliver a testimony of the events. I confess. Okay, as I was saying, those two charges aren't to be contended. In my mind, they're as clear as day. But I'd like to address the third charge of this trial session. The bombing of Chateau, whatever. The murder of Dom Catterline. I plead guilty, you shut your mouth. Not just to the murder of Dom Catterline or Everett, but all two charges. Plead whatever you like, madam. I don't believe you played any part of the attack. You're in jail at the time of the incident. You couldn't possibly have the means... I just realized he has human hands. By the means to even issue an order to a lackey. To help uncover the truth, I shall investigate... Call the investigative officer, Inspector Valert, to the witness stand. What are you saying, playing at, Mr. Sparrowson? What am I playing at? What are you trying to drag me out with this needless pedantry? Dude, I'm doing my job. The prosecutor's role is to only prosecute people for crimes they have actually committed. Uh-huh, whatever. Excellent, on to the questioning. Now, Inspector, why do you believe that Madame Beaumart is behind the bombing of the place? She has a crystal clear motive. The Madame Catterline wants a rebellion. By killing a prominent bourgeoisie figure in a dramatic manner, she stirs up tension between the classes. Evidence? Oh shit. Real evidence? You didn't tell me that before the trial. Well, very well. You all burn for your sins. Jesus, JJ. It was crudely fastened to a pillar around 50 meters from where the explosion thing. You all burn for your sins. This message is no doubt intended as a declaration of violence or warning of what's to come. The poster was damaged in the explosion and thus ensuing the fire. The signatures at the bottom are clearly unreadable. It's evident that two names fit the face perfectly. Those names are... Fontaine and Piero, I guess. I mean, they knew they were rebels because I saw them in the catacombs, but do you really think they did this? Uh-huh, well, it's true, I can't think of any names. No, because there's evidence. Oh, Jesus, really? A cross-examination? This poster was found at the crime scene, declaration of violence, okay, the poster. Uh-huh, this burn edge, that torn corner... Shit, what does our thing look like? The torn corner. The upper right, what about it? Doesn't look a little odd? Not at all. As it happens, I know for a fact that the poster is torn. I have proof. This part. Uh-huh. Let's have a look. Believe in yourself. What is this sentimental rubbish? Somehow self-help pamphlet? Ignore the contents of the note for the moment, Inspector. Focus on the shape of the paper. Oh shit, it's this tear. It looks familiar. You see it too? The torn edge from the note matches the torn corner of the poster. I posit the person who wrote this note is the same who designed and wrote the poster. That's a reasonable claim. I don't need a signature inspector. I know only one person who could leave a note in a place like that. Sorry, bro. I don't want to throw anyone in the horse carriage, especially this person. But, well, in my opinion, the only person who fits... is an explosion! Okay. No? Oh, no, it's rebels. Oh, a big fire. Never mind. No fire this time. Or no rebels this time, just fire. Okay. I told you, no idea what's going on. I need to go, Inspector. I'm telling you, the explosion had nothing to do with me. You honestly played no part in the chateau, and you honestly know nothing about this fire. We have to get out of here. Undo my shackles, please. You aren't going to seriously let me die here, are you? Fine. Of course not. Are we gonna die? For what it's worth, I'm sorry for killing that prosecutor. That's nice. It took the weight off my heart that's been there for years, but I'm starting to think that what I did was, well, it wasn't justice. I don't think it was, at least. Hey, here's the key. Undo your chains. Yep. Right, sounds good. Try Britain, or maybe America. I hear America is nice. I thought prosecutors were all about punishing the guilty. I don't know much about being a prosecutor, man. I've only had this job for 4 days, after all. But I do know that Kokoriko wouldn't call a person burning to death justice even if the person were guilty. I'm just following his example. Oh, man. Was Kokoriko I saw as a child different than the Kokoriko I killed? I don't know. I hear people can change, but we really don't have the time for that discussion. Because, you know, fire aim and attempt and stuff. Okay. I'm meeting the inspector out front, so you may want to take the back exit. The inspector would see us both hanged if he knew what I just did. Okay. You were a first-rate lawyer. 4 days on the job. Any problems? Nah, man. Nope, no problems at all. Building's on fire from riverside to riverside. We need to get this island right away. There's something important I need to tell you. We need to tell you about the Viridian Killer and the shit getting real. Oh god. What's up? This place is utter chaos. I really need to tell you this. I really can't. Falcon told me something. I thought he was just saying stupid things because he was angry and stressed, but after the incident, and now this, I think he might have been telling the truth. Falcon told me that he was the Viridian Killer. Well, are you okay? I knew it! Run along, Sparrison. Get off this island safely. No, I think I'm going to arrest the Viridian Killer. I've hunted him for 18 years, and now I finally have my opportunity. I don't know what that's about. Oh, who cares? Maybe he's just taking the blame for the wolf, maybe? I don't know. Are you going to arrest Falcon? But you know where he is. I do know where he is. The arrogant Phil's depute is watching us right now. I don't see him. Like I said. Okay. What I do now? Look at that. Okay, never mind. Maybe this is something else. Such a beautiful view. A perfect place to watch the city burn. Who the hell are these two? Oh, Inspector, it's about time. Oh, are these the two wolves, actually? Because they'd still be alive in this damned future. You. I knew it. You were the one responsible for the bombings of the July Revolution, and you're the one responsible for the bombings of today. You are the Viridian Killer. Yeah. Okay. You knew before Sparrison told you, didn't you? How long have you known? Okay, maybe he is, and then, like, one of the wolves is his lackey taking the fall. In which case, that's really funny. Well, that's fine, because in the good future, he's totally a bro. A falcon acting as a defense lawyer? Laughable. It is in your nature to be a bird of prey. But it wasn't until Kokoriko and I carried out an investigation that my suspicions turned to evidence-based reasoning. Because you wanted to distance from yourself for the Oath Identity. So I created a perfect scenario. You're a fool, Inspector, but I can't fault your intuition. I suppose you wish to arrest me. Uh-huh. Justice. You talk as if I'm the only one who stands here as a sinner. You, Inspector, are just as guilty as I am. You're the one responsible for Severin Kokoriko's death. You are the one who ordered him to undertake a mission that he had no chance of completing. You knew, from the moment that you sent him to confront the rebels, that he would be killed like a street dog. And for what? To anger me? To make me lash out? Well, it worked. You succeeded. Here I am as the Viridian Killer. Kokoriko is dead and Paris is ablaze. Dozens have died so you can fulfill your lust for punishing criminals. Is that justice? I have broken no law, I have done no wrong. You think laws define what right and wrong? That's a disgusting level of naivety. Regardless of what's written in the law books, we are both sinners from the worst kind, Inspector. We both deserve justice. So let us be judged by the way of ancient regime. Oh, I'm at the edge, man. Let us settle this through the oldest form of trial known to man. Indeed. I'm sure you brought a pistol. I brought my own. I'm not going to duel you. I'm not going to give you a choice. On the count of five, I'm going to turn and shoot. You can participate, or you can be killed. Count. One. Oh, man. Turn and shoot. Oh, no. Justice. Damn. Heh. You shot early. I know it did, and you're a damned hypocrite. Alrighty then. So this is how it ends. Two old birds going up in flame. I can hear the people chanting, liberty, equality, fraternity. Oh, aren't those the two, or the three endings we have, I think. Uh-huh, no, this isn't right. I can't leave things like this. I have a confession. Damn it! Stop doing things! Yes, I bombed Chateau, whatever. I did that to get revenge on an enemy of mine, and yet, I set a city on fire to spite you. But the real Viridian Killer? The one who maimed you in the Dry Revolution? It wasn't me. That would be the other fox, apparently. Oh, you're already gone. Maybe it was for the best that you didn't hear. Truth is overrated anyways. Okay. Not on my watch. Oh no, Sparrowson! Don't bro me like this. This has to be an ending in which I totally die. Wow. He has to try me, right? That's what justice is. Or is he gonna just bro me out? Is the Sparrowson broness gonna overcome justice? Good God. But mentally, I think we'll need a little more time. Mental health care of all of Europe, yeah, like that one crazy guy. Actually, you should take him from a walk by the river. Right. Hi, Sparrowson. Yeah. I haven't gone loopy. Is Sparrowson gonna kill me? He might actually kill me. The king was booted out of the country. France has a new and scary future ahead of it, doesn't it? I heard Judge Maxime granted you a full legal license. I'm a real attorney now. Congratulations, Renardi. You must be proud. I'm gonna be a defense. I'm gonna be a prosecutor. I'm gonna be a proper prosecutor, like Kokoriko. I guess everyone was a better role model of a lawyer than I was, wasn't he? I think we might have a small talk, Falcon. There's something serious I need to discuss. The bombings. Only Inspector Valerian and I knew that you were behind the attack. He only had and I knew that you were the Viridian Killer. So with him gone, it's just me. Uh-huh. Shit. No? No. It's difficult to say. I'm trying to get the handle on justice, Malarkey. Right now? I don't know what's right or wrong. Are you a murderer? Should you have been in prison? I don't know. This whole thing is a mess. I find myself asking, what would Kokoriko do? Probably give a stupid, Valerian quip, I guess. Listen, Sparrowson, I wanted to thank you for not turning me in, but I think I'm going to stay in the hospital for a little while. Or maybe a long while. You can call it penance if you want. Uh-huh. You know? You could just go, make a run for it. I wouldn't be able to catch you. I bet you would make it all the way to, Callius. But I won't. Really? Nice. Of course, I want to fly away more than anything. But some birds need to be kept caged. Why is this so, this shouldn't be as uplifting as the music is doing. But whatever. Okay, so that was the other ending. That was nice. Again, still like the OG one. Not the OG one, but the other one. But I do admit the edge is pretty hilarious. I think it's always nice to see like other sides of like, it's kind of like in Undertale. Like you watch the genocide ending, and then it makes the true ending like kind of even better, unless you do them in a specific order. But like you get to appreciate everything else, like how the boxes around their mouths aren't exactly bright, but that's no big deal. And yeah, I think it was really cool. It just makes you like the other ending, like, cause you know, like when when Severin and the lion finally get along at the very end, that was pretty nice. I think the game would have been really it's really funny how Don Catalan just gets murked. Believe in yourself, Sparrus. And I don't think the ending would have changed if I had decided to turn him in. They probably would have had the exact same conversation, just slightly different. Okay, so now in the next time we can actually get the very last ending. We will probably do that next time on Let's Play Aviary Attorney. But until then, this has been Skid Flash. Hope you've enjoyed watching. Bye.